giving back to the veterans who have given so much to the country. A third thing we're doing, working with the Sierra Club, a partnership we have with them on cool cities, where we're together deploying tens of thousands of advocates on the ground and focusing not just on the kinds of green technologies that we talked about from a building standpoint, but also these transit solutions. Number four, we are working with unions on a number of high-profile projects which we're very excited about. The first, and that you may have read about, is a project that our chapter in New York, Urban Green, is working on with the SEIU's 32BJ, which is sometimes known as the city's Green Supers Program, or Green Superintendents. And originally the vision was 1,000 superintendents of buildings in New York would be doing things, again, that McKinstry might recommend, but maybe even less high-tech things that they can just do in the building themselves, making a huge difference. And in the end, the stimulus funds, the stimulus legislation produced another $2.8 million for the program, and now there's 2,200 New York City building superintendents who are making a big difference. A fourth or fifth item is work we're doing with the AFT and the NEA in the arena of green schools, and working with them specifically on ways to empower teachers and maintenance workers who may not feel like they have any ability to control how well a building performs or how well the occupants are able to be have their environment change so that it's better. But working on such incredibly simple things as just working with teachers to make sure the students actually get the benefit of natural sunlight by having their chairs and tables where the sunlight is, or, I mean, again, many of these things are just incredibly simple, but at the same time make a big difference, and it empowers the people in the schools to feel like they're making a big difference. So I guess I would wrap up by saying that as I heard my fellow speakers, I was very impressed that the greening of many of the trades that we're talking about today is not some sort of external thing where someone is sort of spraying magic dust on people and saying you're green. This is a process of greening from within. The transit workers that we're talking about are beginning to recognize the tremendously positive impact that mass transit has. The people who work on solar are beginning to have an additional sense of pride in what they do. The teachers in green schools have that pride and that sense that they are green workers. Many of us here on the podium have the extraordinary privilege of being green workers, and that's something that I hope we can bring to a lot more people. Thank you very much.
So, first I want to thank the Blue-Green Alliance for convening us. I want to thank the speakers for the presentations here today, but more than that, for the kind of work they are doing to create the green economy of the future. Lastly, there are two big workshops that are going on right after this, one on infrastructure, the other on energy efficiency. You can be helped in trying to get to either of those workshops by just going out in the hallway, and there are folks out there who will help you get there. So thank you so much for coming, and take good care.